Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu amma ba'du fa'uzu billahi minash shaitanir rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin arrahmanir rahim maliki yawmiddin iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in ihdinas siratal mustaqim صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين
O those people who believe, with patience and forbearance ask help from Allah. Surely Allah is with those who are patient. For the sake of obtaining their objectives, divinely appointed jamaats, the commandment that is in the Holy Quran regarding divinely appointed jamaats is that these people, in a perpetual fashion, they continuously submit towards Allah, that is those people from the divinely appointed jamaats. It is prayers and forbearance and patience that gives success to believers. This principle, even before Islam, is found in various other religions. That is, the prophets that came with those different religions also taught this same thing. And the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, similarly provided us with this teaching which he was provided by Allah the Almighty. And this is the commandment that is given to Muslims, that your successes are only going to be achieved through patience and through prayers. Without these two things, without prayer and without forbearance, there is no other route through which you can obtain the objective for which Allah has given you. In the Holy Quran, in various verses of the Holy Quran with reference to forbearance and to patience, or where we have been provided instructions regarding these things, in accordance with these, the definition of patience is in the way of Allah, whatever difficulties, whatever anguishes or whatever difficulties you must face before you, then you must not complain in any way. You must never profess any kind of complaint regarding those difficulties. This is the definition of patience by the Holy Quran. And it is proved from the history of prophets that those who believed in them, we find this in history, that the prophets and their followers, they had to face various kinds of difficulties. And this always happens, that they have to face various difficulties. The Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, who more than him attained the love of Allah? But nonetheless, the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, and his followers, the difficulties that they had to face, they are evident to everyone. Everybody can see those difficulties that the Holy Prophet and his followers had to face. But despite these difficulties, he provided training to his companions that, let alone complaining about anything, rather, whenever they faced any kind of difficulties or any kind of anguishes or whenever any kind of cruelties were perpetrated against them, then always with prayer and with patience they went forward. That is, they used the weapon of prayer and patience to answer these cruelties. It is something else that after a long time, when they faced these cruelties and these animosities against them, after a long period, then because they were human beings, because they were humans, then when a person has to pass through such difficulties, then obviously he becomes quite anxious and worried. And he thinks that when will that time come? When these difficulties that we have been facing and this harshness that we have been facing, when will we be free from these things? When will we attain victory? When will we be triumphant? When will our enemies come under the wrath of Allah? This is what a believer thinks who goes through these difficulties. Allah, reassuring the believers, says that remember that Allah the Almighty is with those of you who are patient. So therefore, to remain attached to Allah the Almighty, that is, remaining with Him in a sense that is not only with Him in this world, but a person who is with Allah is also with Him even after death. A believer, after he passes away, he becomes a recipient of the blessings and rewards of Allah the Almighty. So in order to remain with him in this world and in the next world, Allah the Almighty, by forbearing all those difficulties and by remaining attached and developing a relationship with him, and by praying, you should do these things in order to remain attached with him. This is what you should do, to ask of help and succor from Allah. And how do you have to ask for this help? That is, when you face difficulties, bear them. Do not be anxious or worried by these difficulties. Do not let it cause any doubt to come within you when you have to face these trials and tribulations, and with a perpetual attitude in this regard, and with a continuous effort, you must remain attached with Allah and keep a relationship with Him. It is not that today you pray exceptionally or pray profusely and then later on you do not have great attention towards praying. But actually, the salvation of Allah should always remain in your heart. So when you have these things in you, when you have an attachment with Allah, when you have a relationship with Allah the Almighty, and when you are asking of these things from Allah with prayers, it is then that Allah will bless you for what you have done. Another meaning of forbearance or patience is that with all your capabilities and with all your qualities, you must implement the commandments of Allah the Almighty, and you must continuously implement them. And whatever the situation and whatever the circumstances, you must keep on trying to safeguard yourself from performing sins. So this is another definition of forbearance or patience. So a person who faces difficulties or whatever greeds or attractions are given to him, when a person is given these attractions and he goes away from it, but he does not remove away from trying to attain the pleasure of Allah, and he does not get attracted by those greeds, and this is the higher moral standard and the high standard of patience. And then when a person tries to perform pious actions, and when he tries to establish high moral standards, and when he goes through difficulties to do this, then you should go through this to do this. This is also a type of patience, going through difficulties in order to do these things. So thus, when for the sake of Allah the Almighty, you pass through every kind of difficulty, and when despite being offered all sorts of attractions and greed, you safeguard yourselves from sins, and you remain established on pious things, then that is a person who is truly patient and who is truly submissive. And as I have said previously as well, that these difficulties and these anguishes is, despite having to go through them for a long time, you do not ever have any doubts or complaints towards Allah, and you never have any complaints regarding that person who is sent by Allah, or any doubts regarding him. The people who do this are true believers and people who are truly patient. Nowadays, certain people on Ahmadis, in order to remove them from their faith, they have started making this effort. And I have mentioned this briefly in the past as well, about these people who try to remove Ahmadis from their patients. And what they say is that the Khalifa Waqt and the Jamaat, that is the Khalifa of the time and the Jamaat, they try to put it in you that be patient, that this time of difficulties will go away. And sometimes pamphlets and leaflets have been distributed with this material, and through other means people are spreading this. And what these people say is this, that is those people who raise these allegations, that for 100 years, that is more than 100 years have now passed, and this period of facing difficulties is still established. When will this period finish? You are still facing these difficulties. Although the sentiments of Ahmadis, this is an attempt to try and remove certain sentiments of Ahmadis. They think that Ahmadis perhaps are very weak of faith, and perhaps they will come towards us if we provide sympathy to them. If we are sympathetic towards them, perhaps they will come into our ways. This is what the thinking is of these people. And they provide examples, that give an example of any prophet who had to face through so many difficulties, or whose community had to face through such a long era of difficulties. This is the example they give. There are examples of every prophet. If these people had actually read the Holy Quran, or if they knew anything about history, then these examples are entailed therein. Take the example of the followers of Hazrat Isa, that is the Prophet Jesus. For more than 300 years, in certain areas, they actually had to hide in caves. And this is how they spent their lives, hidden in caves. So this actually is an attempt by the opponents that they should try every kind of means, every kind of satanic attempt to try and remove believers from their faith. There perhaps are one or two people who are influenced by this, but the vast majority of the believers, they remain established on their belief and on their faith. And all these kind of griefs and all these kind of difficulties and attractions does not ever remove them from their belief and their faith. And not only this, but in fact, these difficulties, not only do they not have any complaint or doubt against the Holy Prophet, but they do not have any doubt against Allah. Because these are those people who provide high display high standards of forbearance and patience. And they establish high examples of forbearance and patience and submissiveness. As I said, sometimes there are worries because we are humans, and sometimes people have certain worries and anxieties. And the followers of every prophet in the past have actually said this. For example, before the migration in Makkah, despite the fact that the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, his companions, they actually gave their lives in sacrifice for the faith, and they faced every kind of cruelties, and they forbeared every kind of difficulty and anguish, and they were ready to bear all of this. But despite this, they actually asked this question to the Holy Prophet, and they did not ask this because their faith was weak. This is not the reason why they asked this question to the Holy Prophet. These people were very strong in their faith. But they actually told the Holy Prophet about their anxieties, and they said, when will we have to bear these difficulties until? And the difficulty and the anguish on the face of the Holy Prophet, this is why they said this, because they saw the anguish on his face, that how long will you have to bear this? When this question was asked to the Holy Prophet, Then one of the companions said to the Holy Prophet that when we mentioned our difficulty and our anguishes to the Holy Prophet, then the Holy Prophet was actually near the Holy Kaaba and he was lying down there on a kind of sheet. And we said, do you not ask Allah for help for us and do you not pray for us that Allah may He finish these days of difficulty? And the Holy Prophet replied to this, that before you, such humans have passed, that because of their oppositions of the Holy Prophet, oppositions against them, they had to face all kinds of difficulties, and they faced every kind of anguish, and people put things on their head, and sometimes their head was broken into two. But despite all these cruelties, they never moved a step away from their faith, despite all these horrific barbarism, that sometimes even in a cannibalistic fashion, people used to remove their flesh and they used to remove their bones. But despite all of this, these people in the past, they were never removed away from their faith. So this example was given by the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, to his companions. So the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, he provided a golden principle to those early companions. That is, these difficulties do come and they will come. Those who oppose, they will reach the heights of cruelties and the heights of oppression. But these heights of oppression do not remove the believers from their faith one single bit. But in fact, because of forbearance, because of patience, they bear all of this quietly. So therefore, Hazur says, if with prayers and with patience you keep asking of the succor of Allah, not only will you be saved from this oppression, but in fact you will become triumphant over this oppression. The promised Messiah, peace be upon him, once a person also asked him for prayer. And he was actually very worried and very anxious that a Maulvi in his village, he was giving him a lot of pain and a lot of difficulty. And he said, please pray that this person is removed from here. When the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, heard this, he smiled when he heard this. And he replied to that person that in this community, when you enter this community, then you should adopt the teachings of it and you should implement it. If you do not face difficulties, then where will the blessings lie? The Prophet of Allah, the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, for 13 years he faced these difficulties and this oppression. Do you not have news of that time of the Holy Prophet when he faced these difficulties? The Holy Prophet gave the teachings of patience to his companions. And in the end, all these enemies were destroyed. A time is near when you will also see that these evil people will not be seen anymore. And the promised Messiah said that it is Allah's will that this pure community, it will be spread in the entire world. At this time, they see you less in numbers and they give you these difficulties. But when this Jamaat will become big in number, these people will quiet down themselves. And if Allah wanted, these people would not have provided any difficulty. And those who are giving those difficulty would not have even been born. But through these people, Allah wants to give this teaching of patience and forbearance. You will see after a short time of patience that this was nothing. That person who provides difficulties, he either repents or he is destroyed. Many letters like this are received that we started abusing, but now we have repented after doing abuse, and now we have taken the pledge of initiation, we have performed bid. And the promised Messiah continues that patience is a type of worship, and Allah said the person who is patient will be provided that reward for which you cannot even envisage. It is countless, that is, unlimited amounts of blessings will descend on such people. These rewards are only for those people who are patient. Allah's promise is not with other people who are not patient. When a person supports such a person, then when he faces all sorts of difficulties, then in the end, the person who supports him, he gains a sense of honor and he destroys the person who is giving difficulty. Similarly, our Jamaat is being supported by Allah. It has the succor of Allah and that difficulty will be removed itself. There is nothing like patience. So Hazur says, this statement of the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, in 1902, which he replied to that person. Then by coincidence, I was searching through various references. Then, by coincidence, this was the month of November in 1902. So this was said by the Promised Messiah 108 years ago. But anyhow, in this, the Promised Messiah, peace be upon him, when you ponder on his words and the truth of the Promised Messiah, that is, the truthfulness of the Promised Messiah himself, it shows how the Promised Messiah was fully trustworthy of the words of the Allah the Almighty. And these were the words of the Promised Messiah, that I am surely the chosen one of Allah, and Allah's help will certainly come. It will surely descend upon us. With all these reassurances of Allah, and with all these prophecies and glad tidings, it was a result of all of these things to the Promised Messiah, peace be upon him, that with this belief and with this firmity, he said this statement which I have just read out. So actually, this was a type of prophecy. And today, with great blessings like the sunshine, we are seeing these prophecies being fulfilled every day. When the Promised Messiah, peace be upon him, said that it is Allah's will that this pure Jamaat, it will be spread all over the world. Today, by the grace of Allah, this community is spread all over the world. And these people are making some kind of effort. That is, those people who oppress Ahmadis, who are cruel to Ahmadis, they make these efforts. And they try to provide every kind of anguish on the Ahmadis. They try to perpetrate every kind of cruelties on the Ahmadis. For example, in schools and colleges in Pakistan, the children of those schools who are Ahmadis, the people trouble them. They try to remove them from the schools for being Ahmadis. And similarly, those people who are performing some kind of job or in some kind of work, they try to harm them in whatever way they can. They even try to hurt them physically, and as a result of these things, many Ahmadis have been martyred because of these actions and efforts by these opponents. But despite all these efforts against the Ahmadiyya community is spreading all over the world. And not only this, for example, if this is happening with certain students in Pakistan, or oppression is being performed against Ahmadis in Pakistan, then there are also places outside of Pakistan where people have tried to get education, and not only have they been successful in it, but in fact it has become a means of spreading the message of the Ahmadiyya community, those people who were perpetrated cruelties against in their work. Then those Ahmadis actually started going outside of Pakistan and working there. And not only did they spread their own work there, but they spread Ahmadiyyat in this way. Then there are the martyrdoms. Certain people have had to migrate because of these martyrdoms, and their families have had to migrate because of these martyrdoms, and because of this, the community is spreading all over the world. But in fact, this spreading of the Ahmadiyya community, that is according to the decree of Allah the Almighty, which the Promised Messiah, peace be upon him, has mentioned. In accordance with this, because of this opposition and cruelty to Ahmadis, the Ahmadiyya community is spreading even faster than before. And those people who oppress Ahmadis are becoming a means of the Jamaat Ahmadiyya spreading all over the world. The Ahmadiyya community is being introduced all over the world in a way that you cannot even envisage. You will be totally surprised by it. Outside, that is outside of Pakistan, the number of beds, the number of people initiating into the community is raising on a daily basis. So thus, when this is happening, and when the community is spreading despite these efforts of the opponents, and when the prophecy of the Promised Messiah, peace be upon him, and the promises of Allah the Almighty are being fulfilled in a splendid and exemplary manner, then inshallah, by the grace of Allah, this prophecy will also be fulfilled. That when this community will be grown to such an extent that these people will quieten themselves. This is according to the words of the Promised Messiah. So therefore, our efforts in this regard must be this, that in order to we must make every effort in this regard. And what must our efforts be? Our efforts must be this, that in order for us to partake in the blessings of Allah the Almighty, Allah says, propagate the message, perform tabligh, spread the message. So otherwise, this speed of this propagating or the spread of the Jamaat, it is not the result of any human efforts in any way. As the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, has said, that letters are received, that we are repent, and then we join the Jamaat. Those same people who are actually opposing the Jamaat before, now those same people are writing letters that we have repented and now we are entering the community. Hazur says, this same way is also being seen today as well. In fact, we are seeing this in scholars and priests against the Jamaat Ahmadiyya, that the truth of Ahmadiyya is being embedded in their hearts, and they are actually saying that we want to perform the bid. This is even amongst the priests. We see this amongst the priests and the scholars even. So this revolution within the hearts is being performed by Allah the Almighty. So therefore, if with prayer and with patience, we ask for the succor and the help of Allah the Almighty, and we remain submitted before Allah the Almighty, then inshallah, we will see this revolution take place. That we will see these small numbers transform into large numbers. Those people who raise these allegations, if they are born in the world, they will also see this. If they do not see this, their children will see this. As the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, said, that you will see that the time is near, that you will see this, that these evil people will not be seen anymore. So Hazur says, those evil people will be destroyed themselves at that time. So therefore, these victories and these triumphs is given by Allah the Almighty to those people who have strong faith. It is given to those people whose levels of patience and forbearance are of the highest degree. It is given to those people who have full belief in the prophecies of Allah. These temporary difficulties and anguishes actually do not cause any effect in a negative way to them. And actually, these are seen by these people as an opportunity to go even further. So it is our objective that we must, with these temporary difficulties, with patience and forbearance, pass through all of this. And in our prayers, we must give even more attention towards praying towards Allah. Allah the Almighty has also said this in one place, that with prayer and with forbearance, who are those people who work in this way? And Allah the Almighty says, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا لِلْخَاشِئِينَ. That with prayer and with prayer and with patience, ask for help with Allah, and apart from those who are humble or display humility, it is not with any other people. So Hazur says, in other words, only those people can go forward in terms of their relationship with Allah, and only those people develop patience within them who actually also develop humility. A proud person or an arrogant person can never show patience or forbearance. A proud person or an arrogant person will never submit or prostrate before Allah as is the way that he should really prostrate before Allah. And when this does not happen, then you will remain deprived of the support and succor of Allah the Almighty, the promised Messiah, peace be upon him. When Allah the Almighty said this to him, that I like this humility of yours, then this was also a proclamation that by the grace of Allah the Almighty, for that work for which the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, was made him stand up for, that is, the promised Messiah was made to be stood up for by the Allah the Almighty, Allah was proclaiming here that inshallah, the promised Messiah will be given a triumphant victory in the end. That work that is about to be given to you, this is Allah speaking to the promised Messiah, peace be upon him. Allah will bless it so profusely, so abundantly, that its result in the end of all this, its result of all of this will mean that despite all the opposition and all the difficulties, you will still attain victory. The final result will be victory in your mission. And by the grace of Allah, Hazur said, this is happening. So, we Ahmadis do not have any doubt in this at all, that the opposition against Ahmadiyyat can never provide any obstacles in the way of Ahmadiyyat spreading. The Holy Quran mentions the help and support of Allah in various places. And in various places in the Holy Quran, Allah has told us that for our believers and for those people who I appoint, I support them. This is what Allah says in the Holy Quran. And these things which are mentioned therein, they actually strengthen our faith. And they strengthen us and make us believe that inshallah the final victory of Ahmadiyya will happen. A believer's life is spent for the sake of attaining the pleasure of Allah. And in this life and in the life to come, that is the life after his death or after he passes away, this belief remains within him. That Allah the Almighty, for the sake of Allah the Almighty, difficulties and problems that you have to face, that you will face all of this, and if you do face all of this, then inshallah you will become the recipient of Allah's rewards in the life to come. That is, if you face these difficulties, this is what the belief of a believer is. So surely and certainly this is according to the promise of Allah the Almighty. And this will inshallah be a means of making you meet Allah, that is facing these difficulties. Allah says about those who display humility and humbleness, whilst reassuring them, الَّذِينَ يَزَنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مَلَاكُوا رَبِّهِمْ وَأَنَّهُمْ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Allah says in this place of the Holy Quran that these are those people, that is those people who show humility and who provide forbearance and show forbearance and patience and who pray. These are those people who believe in this, that they are going to meet their Lord. And they believe that they will return to their Lord and they will establish a relationship with Him. So Hazrat says, in this verse of the Holy Quran, in the verse that I mentioned before, the summary of this is that patience and forbearance and remaining steadfast and those people who ask for the help of Allah in their happiness and whenever they are sad as well, they always submit towards that one Allah, that one God. These are those people who always show humility whenever they do all of this. And as a result of that humility, they become the recipients of Allah's rewards and blessings. They never display any kind of arrogance or pride, and they never display this in this life. And also for the sake of attaining the life to come, they make every effort into this effect. That is, a believer, in order to safeguard himself from those difficulties that have been brought forward by those people who oppose him, he submits with humility and humbleness to Allah and he asks for Allah's help and succor. And that patience and that forbearance and steadfastness and that prayer actually increases him in humility, so that he becomes even more the recipient of the blessings of Allah. He receives even more of his blessings. And you never see any slack in their steadfastness. If it is Allah's commands, if it is Allah's command that in this world for the sake of the faith, war is forbidden, as the Prophet Messiah, peace be upon him, came and proclaimed that war is forbidden right now, then these people give up their life, but in terms of prayer and patience do not always display this. But other people do display this patience and prayer, because these people know that this world is temporary and in the world to come we will have to meet Allah. So therefore these people know that we have to follow the commandments of Allah, as the Prophet who was sent by Allah has taught us about. We can give our lives, is what these other people say, that we can give our lives, but we cannot remove ourselves or move away from those teachings that have been given to us. So therefore, those people who, this is a message to those people of those jihadi organizations who actually in the name of Islam perform these terrorist acts and perform these suicide missions, and they are destroying the peace of the world and they are killing innocent people. This is a message to these people that these actions of yours are not accepted in the light, in the view of Allah. If after you kill these innocent people, you want to develop a relationship with Allah, do not say this is for the sake of Allah, because it cannot be. That is killing innocent people. But in fact, what your efforts must be is this, that we must take on board humility. We must adopt humbleness and humility, and we must take the mantle of steadfastness and prayer. And in order to show that we are better, we must not destroy the laws of the country, and we must not make efforts to destroy the rules, because these are signs of pride, arrogant and proud people. And Allah never helps those people who are proud or arrogant. Today, this honor, this thinking, by the grace of Allah, is of an Ahmadi, that is to be patient and to pray, that is with humility. An Ahmadi, he always remains in search of the help and succor of Allah the Almighty, and with humility and with humbleness, he submits before Allah and he prostrates before Him, and he takes the route of humbleness and humility. This is the route he chooses, and he moves forward and he goes forward in terms of performing pious actions. And he takes the honor of Inna Allaha Ma'as Sabireen, that surely in every difficulty, in every anguish, he will always be patient and ask for prayer from Allah. And even he does not think that giving up my life is any kind of difficulty. It is such people that Allah the Almighty has given this glad tiding. Ulaika alayhim salawatum min rabbihim wa rahmatun wa ulaika humul muhtadun. And Allah has given this glad tiding to such people, as is mentioned in the Holy Quran, that these are those people who from their Lord are given all sorts of blessings and rewards, and whose mercy descends upon them, and these people are the ones who are truly guided. So thus Hazrat says, whatever anyone wants to say about us, they can say it, and they can keep on saying it about us. That even after such a long period of tribulations and trials, this proves that you are false. We do not care about this at all, because Allah the Almighty is with us. Allah the Almighty, in these difficulties and these tribulations, because of our patience and because of our forbearance, is providing us with all sorts of blessings which we are seeing with our own eyes. And it is us alone, that is we Ahmadis, who have been given this reward of being the rightly guided. So therefore, to this effect, it is our work that whatever comes before us, we should never leave that mantle of patience and prayer. Whatever happens, never leave hold of that mantle of patience and forbearance, so that we can keep on being the recipient of the rewards of Allah. May Allah enable us to do this. After this, I would like to mention of a martyrdom, and also mention something regarding somebody who was martyred in Multan, Sheikh Mahmud Ahmad Sahib, son of Nazir Ahmad Sahib. On 8th November 2010, on the day of Monday, at approximately 7:45 p.m. in the evening, he and his son were leaving their shop. They were actually returning home from the shop, and when they reached near to their house, then a stranger on a motorbike started firing upon them. And the son who was riding the motorbike and Sheikh Saab was sitting behind him. And the person who fired on them fired from behind and he passed away. Sheikh Saab was hit by 3 bullets and one of the bullets was hit on the son who was riding the motorbike. And as a result of the firing, Sheikh Saab was martyred. To Allah we belong and to Him we shall return. The son is in hospital. May Allah enable him to return to good health. The son also showed great bravery when we spoke in Rabwa, or when they spoke to him from Rabwa, he said, do not worry, he said that, "I do not care about these bullets, they cannot remove me from my faith." This is what this brave young boy said. "We are totally remained established on our faith, we do not care about these bullets." This is what that son said. The grandfather of the person who martyred took the bet in 1907 at the hands of the promised Messiah, peace be upon him. So this means he has the glad tiding of being a companion of the promised Messiah. His father then took bet the initiation at the hands of the second Khalifa, Hazrat Muslim Maud. And then these people lived in Quetta, and then they moved to Multan later on. In approximately 1935, they moved to Multan. And about 2 months ago on Multan, the mosque that was attacked, his nephew was also martyred. These people work in the industry. This is why the opponents, their work or their industry or whatever their employment is actually running very well. And because of this, the opponents actually had their eyes cast on these people because of their successes in their employment field. Sheikh Sahib and his brothers, at various occasions, at various times, they also had the honor of being Hasir Rahine Mola, that is, prisoners in the way of Allah. And these people always had cruelties perpetrated against them. Similarly, previously, one of his brothers, Sheikh Mukhtar Sahib, he was actually exiled from his district. And then, in 1974, Hazrat Dulana Mulana Doshai Sahib, when he used to help him, then whenever references he required, then Sheikh Sahib was actually at that time in Islamabad. Then he went there twice. And then for the sake of obtaining references, he obtained that book and he brought it for that assembly which was taking place. It was used therein. So that means even in his young age, he was also a great servant of the Jamaat by the grace of Allah. In 2008, he was actually imprisoned and then he was released later on. He was actually kidnapped, but then what happened is he was released later. But then when the people who kidnapped him saw that he was somebody who actually prays and performs tahajjud and reads Quran, then their hearts softened. That is, the people who kidnapped him on ransom. Then they actually started giving him some kinds of comforts, such as a fan and some water. And similarly, those people who were asking for ransom, they asked for less ransom. This is the state of these people. And also, a short while ago, a bomb was placed before the shop, and these people were harmed in the shop slightly. But since these people are in this place, Murdan, then himself and his families are facing these cruelties. May Allah the Almighty increase the rank of the person who has been martyred, and may the family of these martyred be safeguarded, and may all these Ahmadis in Pakistan, in whatever city they are, be safeguarded, because the intention of these opponents are increasing and worsening at every moment. This person who was martyred always observed his prayer, he listened to his sermon, and he used to tell other people about the sermon, that is, his family. He also used to work for the sake of the society, and similarly in Murdan, for the sake of providing cold water, he used to give water from a water cooler which he had formed. He has two sons who he leaves behind. One of them is injured, who is the elder son. And he also has two daughters. The ages of the children are from 28 to 20 years. That is, apart from the wife, he has two sons and two daughters. May Allah the Almighty give all of them forbearance to bear this anguish, and may always safeguard them. After the prayer, by the grace of Allah, inshallah, I will perform the funeral prayers, the janazah prayers, in absentia. inshallah, and also by the grace of Allah, Chaudhry Muhammad Siddiq Sahib, who used to be the Khilafat Library in charge. In the last few days he has passed away. He's been serving Jamaat for a long time. He was a Waqf Zindagi, a life devotee, and in 1915 he was born. In 1906, his father took the initiation into the Ahmadi community. His mother was already an Ahmadi from before this. And in 1935, he studied in Punjab University and took the third position. Then he joined Jamia Ahmadiyya. And then after that, he was released from Jamia, and for the sake and in to the second Khalifa, he said, "I want to devote my life." Then he attained a BA and he did a diploma in library science, and he was a librarian of Khilafat Library. In approximately 1964, he had a great interest to study, so he actually started classes of MA Arabic in Talim al-Islam College. Then amongst the first batch of students, he was among them. And in university, when he studied Arabic, he was the number one rank. He took the first position. Then he was also a member of another organization set up by one of the Khalifas. And then he was also a part of the National League. He also, at the beginning of Khudam al-Ahmadiyya, he was amongst its early members when it first was initiated. And he was also the editor of Khalid Mu'tamid, General Secretary. He was also served in that capacity as well. At that time, the second Khalifa, Hadhrat Muslim Maud, was actually himself the Sadr Majlis Khudam al-Ahmadiyya. Then when the migration was taking place, then with Hadhrat Ammajan and the family of the Prophet Messiah, he took the delegation there for the migration. He was also a part of the Furqan Battalion, and then later on, in 1948, the land of Rabwa, the tents that were put up there, he actually was made in charge of organizing all the tents there. And he had the honor of spending the first night in Rabwa with that delegation. When he went to Rabwa for the sake of migrating and living there, then Hadhrat Muslim Maud was to come after. Then he was sent before so that the tents and all the organizations could be made. So along with Abdul Salam, Akhtar Sahib took all the tents with all the people who were made appointed to come. Then because of the flood, the ways were cut off. Then they had to come from a much longer route around that. At that time, the Talim al-Islam school used to be in Jinyot temporarily. And the headmaster was Sayyid Mahmudullah Shah Sahib, and he said to him that we have to stay there the night. So can you please send some lanterns so that we could see what is happening in the night? And when they reached Rabwa, the sun was setting at that time. Then he made an estimate that the land of Rabwa, that where is the center of it? And he put the tents up in that center. Then the local people used to pass through that area, and they were very surprised. What are these people doing there? Nevertheless, the trucks that were coming with the luggage, they left and they sat there, these two people, and they sat there and they prayed and they started singing poems and nazams. And they started reciting the poem of the Promised Messiah, peace be upon him. And then they said at that time, because there was no population, it was just these two people, there were mountains all around. Then that voice of their poems used to echo from the mountains even further. And they saw that from far, they saw some small kind of light from far away. And when they had said to that Shah Sahib earlier that send the lanterns with the students of your school, then they saw that at about 6 miles at a distance, these students and these young boys were bringing these lanterns for them. And two of those boys were Bengali and one of them from somewhere else. But nevertheless, these children as well, at night time, they reached quite late, and then later on, Ahmadnagar, which is a village nearby, food came from there. And this is how they spent that first night in Rabwa. Similarly, there are many important works that he had performed with the second Khalifa, for example in 1940. For the sake of the shortage of scholars and preparing youngsters, certain programs were made to learn certain things and to debate with other scholars. He was a part of that scheme as well. So his services have a long history. He has performed many services for the Jamaat, and he was retired when he was a librarian of the Khilafat Library, Rabwa. May Allah increase him in rank. He was also a member of Tariq-e-Jadid. He was also amongst the early members of Sadr Anjuman Ahmadiyya. He was also amongst the Anjuman which was made after it came to Pakistan. He also remained the Sadr of Umumi in Rabwa. He performed many services for the Jamaat. And what I have seen is this, that he was an elderly person. He was quite older than me and him. There's a large distance of age between me and him. But apart, even though this is the case, I saw that whenever he met anyone, he met him with great humility and humbleness. And he was a very loyal and committed person. He remained Sadr Umumi for some time as well. Whenever there was a need of any sort, then he used to always be there ready to perform any service. But he had a good sense of organization. May Allah increase him in his rank. Apart from this, there will also be the janaza, the funeral in absentia of him. Then there is a third funeral in absentia, Masroor Ahmad Khurshid Sunuri Sahib. His death has been 2 months in the passing. He passed away 2 months ago. And he has also served the Jamaat in various capacities, particularly in Karachi and also in the US. His daughters are also serving the Jamaat, and Alhamdulillah, their progeny even after that are serving the Jamaat. May Allah also increase him in progeny. All of their funerals in absentia, janaza, ghaib will be performed after the Friday prayers.
Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل واللسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر